So we shall see data types in Java, quick review of that, few references, the course outcomes, course overview, and till now, what are all the Java applications and what is JVM, what is JRE, what is JDK, and the importance or usefulness of IDE, the structure of Java program, meaning of each and every keyword used in the basic Java code, and how do we run the simple Java program. So today, quickly review the basic data types again. So two broad categories of Java data types are primitive and non-primitive data types. Primitive means very basic data types. And non-primitive are derived, like derived data types. Our classes, inheritance, all the, sorry, interfaces, all these are coming under non-primitive data type. So under primitive, we have Boolean and numeric category. Boolean is a new type in Java, as I told. Boolean is the keyword to be used to create the data type. And under numeric category, character and integral part, two subcategories we have. And the character is char, it is similar to C programming. Integral, we have two parts, integer and floating point values. Integer is having four different primitive types, byte, short, int, and long. And under floating point, we have float and double, two different things. So you could see character is coming under numeric value. So though we are using this char data type to store the characters, alphabets, symbols, and all, essentially it is coming under a numeric type. Internally, the compiler understands it using the corresponding code number value. For example, in ASCII code, you might have seen small a is 63, capital A is something. Likewise, even though we are typing ABCDE, the computer understands with the corresponding code, corresponding numeric value. So it has been categorized under this numeric data type. So the size of each of these data types is summarized here. So for Boolean, the default value is false and the default size is only 1 bit, only 1 bit, either 0 or 1. Character, the default value is unsigned 000. And the default size for character is 2 bytes. And for byte variable, default value is 0 and default size is 1 byte. And for short data type, default value is 0 and default size is 2 bytes. And for integer, for all the numeric values, the default value is 0. But for long, or to represent it is a long value, we'll be representing it as 0L. Integer and float, both are having 4 bytes. Long and double, both are having 8 bytes. So in that way, it has to be represented. So these are about Java's basic data types, and these are the corresponding sizes. So this you have to remember while using. And you could see for representing float value, both though it is 0.0, we are giving it as 0.0F because 0.0 can be either float or double. So to specifically mention it is a float value so that only 4 bytes will be occupied. So we have to give 0.0F. If anything is not given, simply 0.0 means by default it is taken as double. So if I give 0.0, that is by default double. 0.0 as well as 0.0D, both are considered as double. So now, Java is a strongly typed language. So normally C and C++ are not strongly typed language. So by while using in an expression, if we give by mistake a different type, like A equal to B plus C, B is different data type, C is different data type, and A is different data type. So in that way, automatically C language tries to give something, truncating the values likewise. But here, the Java compiler checks for the compatibility of the variable when we are using it in an expression. So if I am trying to assign this 4-byte value into a short value, okay, so I have an int value that I am trying to assign in a short value. So 4 bytes tried to be stored in 2 bytes means it is completely wrong. But instead, if this 2-byte value I am trying to store in an integer, yes, that is accepted because enlarging. So 2-byte can be accommodated in 4 bytes, but 4 bytes cannot be accommodated in 2 bytes. So that's why Java strictly checks for all the compatibility when we are using the data types. So expanding is allowed, shrinking is not allowed. Okay, so we should remember the size. So accordingly, we can give the values in the expression. Okay. So now, the two reasons why we are calling Java as a strongly typed language. First reason is every variable has a type that we all know, and every expression has a type. Expression means A plus B plus C into B likewise. That is an expression. So every expression has a type. So A and B are integer. C and D are short integer means finally all are converted into the longest size. Or short. So any one size it has to come. Okay. So the final expression must have a type. So according to the values what we are giving different types. So finally, that will convert the whole result into the highest value, the highest data type value. So every expression has a type. And next, every type is strictly defined. So each and every data type is strictly defined with its default value and its default size. Next. All assignments like A equal to B. So A and B both are same type means okay, no problem. But A is integer, B is short integer. So short is assigned to int. So 2 bytes we are trying to allocate in 4 bytes allowed. But A is short, but B is integer. 4 bytes we are trying to store in 2 bytes. So that is not allowed. So whether explicit or via parameter passing. So I hope you remember what is parameter passing. While we use function, we'll be passing parameters, arguments. So while passing those values are passed and available to the function. Inside the function, they are available as a local variable. So while passing also, it is to be carefully given whether we are giving the corresponding type value. So, and in all the places, Java checks for compatibility. Okay, so we are calling Java as a strongly typed language. Okay, so strictly it will check for compatibility. As I told, for expansion, automatic conversion will happen. For shrinking, it will report an error before compilation, and we have to correct it. Either typecasting we have to do, or we have to change the data type. So we'll be seeing examples on that also afterwards. So first data type we have seen is Boolean. It is used to store only true or false. Okay, either true or false, that only we can store. So what is the purpose of this? So mainly to check for availability. If it is available or not. Available means true, not available means false. Or some flag checking, like some operation is performed, make the flag true now. If it is not performed, make the flag false now. So some condition checking. Okay, so for that this Boolean type is useful. So as it is using only one bit information, the size cannot be defined precisely, because byte means that is the proper size. Only one bit means we couldn't exactly define the size of a Boolean variable. So the sample syntax to use Boolean variable is Boolean any variable name b, b1, okay, or 1 is equal to true or false. Only two values we can give. So this is the sample usage of Boolean variable, sample declaration statement of Boolean variable. Next, char. So this is as I have told, normally char data type in C programming is 8 bit, that is 1 byte, but here it is 16 bit, that is 2 bytes. Character in Java occupies 2 bytes. So ASCII code has only 0 to 255. These many different values are available in ASCII code. So in that ASCII code, if you go and refer 0 to 9, then small a to small z, capital A to capital Z, and then capital A to capital Z, and then plus minus, all these special symbols. So only these values are available in the ASCII table. So only 256 symbols are possible. But Java tries to give code for the regional languages also. So the other characters, other than small a to small z and capital A to capital z, other values can also be represented for coding. So it follows 16-bit Unicode. So with this ASCII code, 8-bit means 2 power 8 different combinations. So that is 256, 0 to 255, totally 256. Including 0. So only that many characters we can represent. But with 16 bits, 2 power 16 combinations we can go with. So 65,536. 0 to 65,535. Totally 65,536. So those many different characters are possible. So you could see where 256 is there and where 65,535 is there. Very, very, very big value, right? Very, very big value. So we could say Tamil language, Hindi language, any, whatever we want, all those things we can have unique code that we can represent using this Java language. Okay. So you can remember, Java's character is based on 16-bit Unicode. Unicode is universally acceptable code for all the characters, A, B, C, D. All the first 255 characters, same, similar to ASCII. Apart from that, it is having so many codes. So you can do Google Unicode table, 16-bit Unicode table. So a table will come, so many characters will be there. ASCII code, you can refer. Okay, so it will show you the possible universally defined codes for that. And it is generally represented using hexadecimal. You could see here. So slash U or slash X we can use to represent the hexadecimal, because longer value, 16 bits I have to give. So 16 bits, if I mention, it is difficult to read. So I'm using hexadecimal notation. This is the reason why you have studied number conversion in problem solving and programming. Because when the size grows, it is difficult for us to write the big number. So we can represent in the form of hexadecimal. So you could see each hexadecimal digit is 4 bits. So 16 bits is difficult for me to write. 1, 1, 1, 1. 4 ones means F. You all agree with that, isn't it? Four ones means yep. So four ones, four ones, four ones, four ones. So totally 16 bits. So that is difficult for me to represent, write and read or whatever. But instead, if I write F, 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 it is easy for me to remember and write, isn't it? So that is the purpose why we have studied number conversion initially when we start programming basics. Okay. Now, char usage. Char, any name for the character variable, and the value we can store, sample value we can store within single quote. This is similar to the C programming language. Okay. Char, ch equal to plus. So this is also a character. Char ch2 is equal to, this is equal to, within double quotes, 9. So now 9 is considered as a character instead of a number. Okay, the corresponding code for 9 is also 9. But for plus, there may be a value, number value for this plus. So this is how we can declare a character variable. Now, integer. Java defines 4 integer types. We have seen byte, short, int, and long. So you can quickly recollect. Byte is 1 byte, short is 2 bytes, integer is 4 bytes, and long is 8 bytes. Okay. All of these are signed positive and negative. All of these are signed means either positive or negative. So in any one value, signed value only. Okay. And as I told, for long it is 8 means we could see 64 bits are there. So 2 power 64 combinations we can have. So I have 2 bits means bit 1, bit 2. So in bit 1, if I fill 0, 0, this is one combination. And 0, 1, this is another combination. 1, 0, this is another combination. 1, 1. So how many possible values I can fill? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 possible values. So 2 power 2 is equal to 4. So 2 bits are there means 4 possible combinations. Here 64 bits are there. So how many combination of values? 2 power 64. So it is a very big value. You could see here, even I couldn't read this. Okay, simply I can read 9223372036854775807. But what is this number? I don't know. I cannot read this like 9 lakhs on that way. It is difficult for me to read. It's a very big number. So it can store up to this value. If a value beyond this, that is 10,223, in that way one number is coming means, or all 0000000, that value cannot be stored in a variable, okay, bigger than this. Normally it is not required. In reality, with these much bigger value we don't use, unless for some security calculation algorithms, like prime number based encryption algorithms, will be having this much big value to securely storing your value by encrypting it. Okay, so that can be that type of information can be stored in a long type of variable. Okay, or some distance calculation or science related calculations, astronomy related, like distance between two planets. Likewise, if you are doing some program means, maybe this type of long variable, this much value may be required. Okay, but for normal calculations, this long is not that much necessary. Sometimes factorial of factorial, if we are doing means, that may result in a higher value, so we can go with long. So we have to think while declaring a variable, what type of values will be storing in that. Accordingly, we can choose. If it is going to be a very big value, then we can go with long. A nominal value only, int. I am going to store age value. What could be the possible data type to store age of a person? Can anyone say? To store age of a person, what could be the nominal value? Can anyone say nominal data type? Sorry, not nominal value. To store the age of the person, whether I should go with long data type or int data type or short or byte. Short. So short takes value from 32,767 positive to minus the. So is there any possibility for age to go up to this value? Yes. By data type itself is enough, because beyond 100 normally nobody would be. Sometimes 108, 109 somebody will be there. But byte itself is enough to store the age of a person. Okay. So accordingly we have to choose the data type. Okay. Good. So do you have any doubt up to this? Okay. So for integer, 2 power 32 combinations. You calculate in calculator what is 2 power 32. So that will be equal to the double of 2,147 million. Okay, it may be around 4,300 and something million. So we are dividing that space into two equal spaces. One range is for positive, another range is for negative. So you could see here for byte, 8 bits are there. So 2 power 8 combinations are there. 2 power 8 is 256. Okay, 2 power 8 is 256. So when I divide 256 by 2, it results in 128. So 0 to 127, 1 half. Another half is minus 1 to minus 128. So totally 256. Okay, so the total number 256 is divided into two. One is for positive range, the other half is for negative range. Two ranges. Okay, and for this also 16 bits. So that is 2 power 16. 2 power 16 means 65,536. If that is divided by 2, that is 32,768. So one half for negative ranges, another half for positive range. So in the positive range, always one less, because zero is coming in the positive range. Okay. So for that, always you could see in the positive range, one value is less than the negative range. Okay. So I hope you got some idea about this. Why this size value is important means, as I told, to store the age of a person, accordingly we have to choose the data type. So for to store the age, simply I am giving int means these many bits are unnecessarily occupied, memory reserved in the RAM that is unused. Okay, only first few bits are used, the remaining. So 8 bits itself is enough, but how many bits we are allocating? 32. So totally 24 bits are always unused. Only one age variable means 24 bits wasted, unused. 4 or 5 age variables I have given means 24 into 4 times. Those many bits are unnecessarily occupied. So for that purpose, I am telling all these. Okay. So next is floating point type. So normally floating point types are also referred as real numbers. And these are used while evaluating expressions that require fractional precision. We have two different types here, float and double. that represent single and double precision numbers. So single precision number is floating point, double precision number is double. So e to the power minus 324. So a very big number after the dot will come. So we'll be giving in the exponential order. Okay, e to the power plus 308, e to the power plus 038 likewise. Okay, so this is the range for float and double. And it you float uses 32 bits of storage normally to represent temperatures. Lower values are floating point precision values. Double uses 64 bits to store a value. It is actually faster than single precision on some modern processes. Okay, then float, this is very fast because it uses double precision. And normally in almost all mathematical functions, it uses double values because of this fast. All these are built-in methods already defined in Java, similar to C. And all these are created with double data type. So now we shall see some sample programs based on data types. So in the source folder, yes, I am creating a new class name I am giving as data samples or data type samples. So yesterday we have seen the naming convention. Normally data type, I mean class names are stored with capital letter, and every next word starting with capital letter likewise. So if we use the same convention, it is easy for others. I wrote a program and you are reading it, means it is easy for you to recognize what is for what purpose. So the name I am giving for this class is data type samples. So I need public static void main, so I am giving like this. So now inside this, one by one we try to use the variables. So first we have seen boolean type, so I am trying to assign a boolean. I try to increase the font size so that you can view correctly. Now I hope you can have some clear perspective. Okay. Boolean B1 equal to true. Boolean B1 equal to true. Now I am trying to print this. System dot out. Dot println. So now I am trying to print B1. So now if this is my code, simply boolean variable is created and it is assigned a value and I am trying to print it. So the value I am assigning is true. I am saving this program and running this. It is representing the value true. Okay, the result is true. Now, I am not giving any value here. Okay, simply B1. Now, I am trying to print this value. Now, we shall check. You could see this editor is reporting an error. As I told, this editor will automatically take care of almost all the mistakes. When we type it in normal notepad, after compilation only, these errors are noted. But editor, while typing itself, it keeps tracking the errors. So here what it is telling, the variable is not initialized. It is telling initialize the variable. So So you could see the suggestion it is telling, Boolean B1 equal to false. So as I told, the default value for B1 is false. Without any initialization, it assumes the value false. Let me try whether it is running. It is telling there is an error in this project. Okay. So now I am canceling this. Okay. So now I am assigning B1 equal to A 3 greater than 4. So now you tell me what value will be printed for B1. Any guesses? You could see after giving this initialization, the red color mark has gone. So now I saved the program. There is no error. I could run. What is the expected result for this program? Any guesses? Yes. 3 greater than 4 is not true. So false is the value. So this operator, this is a relational operator. Always relational operators results with a Boolean value in Java. Okay. Relational operators results with a Boolean value. So 3 greater than 4 is false. Because 3 is a smaller number, 4 is a higher number. So B1 is stored in, false is stored in B1 and that will be printed. So just to tell you, in this way also we can assign values to Boolean variable. Okay, for that purpose I have used this. Okay, and I am giving system.out.println B1. Okay, now I am giving the same line, I am copying. And I am giving inside this 5 is less than 8. 5 less than 8. Okay. So simple relational operator actually I am giving. But even we can give some more combinations and anything. A lengthy expression also we can give. Finally, it will give a Boolean value. In that way also we can give. So here I have given system.out.println directly 5 less than 8. So this will also result in a Boolean variable. So you could see false and true. Okay, first printf statement printed false because 3 greater than 4 is false. Second, 5 less than 8, that is true. So it is printing true. So these are various ways how we can handle Boolean variable. And I can check if B1. If B1 system dot out dot println three is greater than 4. Okay, so if B1 3 is greater than 4, else I am printing system dot out dot println B is not greater than 4. Okay, so now we shall check what it is representing system. So now I am checking these two things. Let me comment. So I am making it in the comment line. This is single line comment. Okay, you can note down. So now the idea is B1 is true means I should print 3 is greater than 4. If it is not true means, so obviously the second one will get printed. 3 is not greater than 4. Okay, so that has been printed. So Boolean variable can be directly used in condition checking. Okay. So that is another way. How do we use Boolean variable? Okay. Now, so next program, let me create. Data type. sample 2. Okay, data type sample 2. I need public static void main and I am giving finish. Okay, next program has been. So now we shall try creating variables like byte. Byte is the char. Next we have seen char. Char ch equal to within single quote a. Okay. Now I can print it using system dot out dot println. I am printing ch. So now a value is printed. When I run this, yes, a is printed. Now instead of printing ch, if I am printing ch plus plus, so first ch value is okay. Ch plus plus, if I am giving means, let me check. So first a value is printed and then it is incremented. But if I give plus plus a, then different value. Plus plus ch. So let me check what is getting printed. B. You could see though it is a character variable, and the plus plus, minus minus, all these are applicable because character is also coming under numeric type. Okay, so that we have seen. So the corresponding numeral value is actually considered by the compiler. Okay, so that we can use that. We can even use this in addition. Char ch1 equal to a and ch2 equal to b. And here I am trying to print ch1 plus ch2. But this normal concatenation without parenthesis I am giving means, this is considered as a concatenation, A, B. Okay. Yes. So A value is what is half of this? 131, 60. Okay, let me print one by one. 60, what is 66 or 7? 65. A is 65, B is 66. So when I add these two, 131 is coming. So first A value and then B value. So when I am using it in addition, then it is considered as a numeric value. When in isolation, if I give, it will print A and B. Okay. So it prints A, B. When I print it separately, when I use it in along with the addition operator, then it is printing it as the original addition of the corresponding numeric value. Okay, so these are the ways how we can use character operator. So we have many manipulation built-in functions that is working on this character. We shall see afterwards all those things. Now we are seeing the basics. So now, next. So with one more program, we shall close the session. Data type sample 2, 3. And I need a public static void main. Yes. So here, now I am trying to use int byte b, then short s and int I long l. Okay, so we can assign values by default. Normally, if I am giving value 3, means that is by default integer. Okay, by default it is integer. So if I am assigning any value, means I should give, like it should be a long value, means 5L. Then it is converted, it is assumed as a long value. So we can assign values like this. Equal to 2. This is equal to 3. And this is equal to 4. This is equal to 5. Okay, so you could see the value of the local variable B is not used. Okay, yes, I am going to use system.out.println. So I can print B equal to B. So to print that, I'll be giving this syntax B equal to. So what should be printed? That is given within double quotes. What value stored in B? That means I should give B without this double quote. So I am pressing enter. Okay. Similarly, all the values I am trying to print. So value of yes equal to yes, and value of I equal to I, and value of L equal to L. As I told, if 5, this 5 is to be considered as a long value, that means that occupies 64 bits, then I should give L here, 5L. Okay, so in that way we can do. So now I am saving this and running this. Yes, B equal to 2, S equal to 3, I equal to 4, L equal to 5. Very, very basic. How do we use this? Similarly, we can use float and double also. Float F equal to 3.3 F. Only 3.3 if I give, that is considered as a double constant, and it is tried to be stored in the float space. So this is the correct usage. Double D equal to 667.2D. Okay. I just tried to give a bigger value, but this is not that much big value. Okay. So similarly, we can try printing these two values. So here I can print F equal to F. D equal to D. So here inside this double quotes, whatever I want, I can give. But this variable name correctly we have to give. So I am saving this and running this. Yes. So all these values are printed as it is. So we can use all these values in expressions also. Some calculation. Okay. To calculate the area of the circle. So normally we go with float value. So likewise, so all those mathematical things and how the shrinking and expansion, all these are happening, we shall see in the next session. Okay. So I hope up to this, you got some idea about how to create the basic Java program. Okay. How to use the data types in the Java program.